Hello students, today we are going to study the inheritance and variations. Now in the last year we have studied what is meant by heredity, inheritance. These are the main features of the life in which heredity, inheritance means what? From the parents to the offsprings, the some characters are transferred and some changes are occurred in their offspring is called as variation. Parents having some characters and different characters will be expressed in their offspring. See in the figure, the color of the hair is different. That means it is the variation occurs in their offspring. It's called as variation. And inheritance means the transmission of the characters from parents to their offsprings or from the one generation to the next generation. It's called as inheritance. Now, George Mendel, he is the father of genetics. Genetics is the branch of science which deals with the study of the gene, the structure, function, and Mendel worked a lot of work on the pea plant, garden pea plant, to explain this inheritance and the changes, that is variation. So Mendel is called as, George Mendel is called as father of genetics. Now these are changes occurs from their parents to their offsprings. That means from one generation to the another generation. Now to explain this mechanism of inheritance, Mendel proves various experiments and works on various experiments and gives the mechanism. Mechanism means how it is transmitted or which factors are there. He discovered that heredity is the transfer of biological characters, and before the chromosome and the gene discovered, he investigated there are some factors or something is there which is responsible for the transmission of the characters from their parents to the offsprings. Okay, now suppose there are parents, one male and female, and in their offsprings some changes are occurred. There are something which is transferred from their parents to the offspring, but which factor, it is not known. It may be chromosome or it may be gene. George Mendel, he is the first gave the accurate explanation for the mechanism of inheritance by using hybridization technique. Hybridization technique means working on different plant species, garden pea plant, which are having different characters and crossing in between them, and this is called as hybridization. And with this technique, Mendel proves that there is something and these factors which are responsible for inheritance, and he will explain with the experiment, with the help of experiments. He worked on garden pea plant to explain inheritance by 7 traits. Now why he selected only garden pea plant? Due to different characters, life cycle completed within 2 to 3 months. That means suppose experiment get failed, he can occur new different varieties within 2 to 3 months. That means species or different characters will be get discovered into the 2 to 3 months. And he processed the data mathematically and statistically. That means he gives the phenotypic expression, genotypic expression in terms of ratio. We learn like this 2:1 or 1:2, like this. That will be, we will see in the next lecture. But he processed this data mathematically and statistically. And to prove this experiment, he selected only garden pea plant with different characters. The 7 pairs he selected, and it also require, this plant also require a smaller area, life cycle completed within 2 to 3 months, so he selected. Now see, द क्रोमोसोम एंड मैकेनिज्म ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस हिज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ हेरिडिटी बिकम द फंडामेंटल लॉज ऑफ हेरिडिटी व्हेन विच व्हेन प्रपोज्ड बाय कॉर्नोस इन 1900. फंडामेंटल लॉज ऑफ हेरिडिटी मीन्स वॉट द लॉज विच कैरेक्टर आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द हेरिडिटी दैट इज कॉल्ड एज द फंडामेंटल्स ऑन विच कैरेक्टर इज प्रेजेंट इन द सेल विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दिस ट्रांसमिशन एंड दिस विल बी रिकॉर्डेड एंड ही विजुअलाइज दैट ट्रेट्स नॉट इनहेरिटेड फिजिकली बट समथिंग समथिंग मीन्स वॉट Inside the cell, gametic cell, there is a chromosome, and on the chromosome, there will be some material which can be responsible for this transmission of the character, and it will be present in the gametic cell. And this something will be coined the term factors. That means in the cell, that one some factor which get transferred to like this another. Gametic cell from suppose from the parent cell to their offsprings through the chromosome with the help of genes is called as the factor. Now he proposed that the factors are particulate in the nature and these factor are now termed as the genes. Now this factor suppose this is the gametic cell. This genes are responsible from the chromosome. They carry the characters from one generation to another generation, means from the parents to their next offsprings or F1 generations. Now, suppose these are the chromosome denoted by capital TT letter and for the tallness, and in the gametic cell. In the gametic cell, it is represented, or the gametes are separated from the diploid cell, like capital T and another capital T. Now these are the gametic cell gametes. Capital T, they are segregated. That means they get separated from one another, and as the haploid number is called as the gamete, which are. Get separated from the cell. Okay. Now we will see. Now he worked that from the cell this material will be transferred to the chromosome. Chromosomes having different characters in the terms of the gene, and gene which is responsible for the heredity. It is explained by different experiments. Now Mendel's success, there are some reasons for the Mendel's success. His experiments were carefully planned and involved large sample. Carefully recorded the number of plants. Now these plants of each type expressed the results of the ratios in the pea plant. Contrasting characters can be easily recognized. Can be easily recognized. Some different seven different characters in the pea plant were controlled by a single factor each. Now number of plants means what? There are too many plants are selected in the ratio. Suppose 2:2, two having one character, two are having different characters. They can be expressed easily. Now for this expression, there are he selected seven different characters in the pea plant, and he easily recognized with the help of these characters. Which are controlled by a single factor each. Seven pairs means what? There suppose the height of the plant, color of the seed, color of the pod, shape of the seed, shape of the pod, flower color, like this. Now these characters can be expressed, or the seven characters which are called as the seven pairs of contrasting characters. Now there are some factors which are located on the chromosomes. Now see the gene. Now gene having some factors or the characters which are present on the chromosome, and chromosomes are present inside this gametic cell or any cell. From this chromosome we get some characters which are situated in the form of DNA, and on DNA there are genes which are responsible for the expression of the characters. Now transmitted from generation to generation. These concepts of the dominance or recessiveness are which are characters transferred from one generation to the F1 generation and get suppressed character is called as recessive character. If capital T and small t are expressed, capital T is called as dominant character. In the cell, there are 46 chromosomes, and in the gamete, while they are forming gametes, there are 23 pairs of the chromosomes in one cell and in another having 23, like this. Now this dominance means what? In F1 generation, the characters are expressed are called as dominant, and suppressed character is called as recessive character. Suppose capital T and small t is present. Capital T is expressed, that is dominant, and small t is expressed is called as recessive. Now if both are present together, but in F1 generation only the dominant character is expressed and this small t is suppressed character, dwarfness, suppose small t is represented for dwarfness, is called as a recessive character. This concept, dominant and recessiveness, are explained by Mendel. This was the one reason. Now we will see these are the seven pairs of contrasting characters. These are also for a 3-mark question, explain the pairs, seven pairs of the contrasting characters given by Mendel for his experiment. The question will be asked like this. Now see, there are seven characters: seed shape, seed color, pod shape, pod color, flower position, flower color, and plant height. Now dominant character and opposite to that is recessive character. Okay, my dominant character, which are the round shape, wrinkled shape, is recessive. Pod shape, inflated, constricted, green, yellow. Flower color, purple, dominant. Axial position, dominant, and tall height, dominant. And opposite to that, suppose seed, rounded seed is called as dominant character, and a recessive character, which is opposite to that, means wrinkled. Wrinkled is called as a recessive character, which is not expressed in F1 generation, is called as a recessive character. Now see, all these are wrinkled, which is opposite to the rounded, is called as a recessive character. Color, suppose we have yellow color dominant and green color recessive color. Pod shape, if we consider pod shape, inflated, green color, purple flower, axial position and tall height, these are dominant character. And opposite to that, wrinkled, green color, constricted are also recessive character, which are opposite to the dominant character, or which get suppressed in F2 generation. These are the seven pairs which are called as the seven pairs given by pairs of characters given by Mendel. Okay.